Edwina Curry's going to be looking through the papers for us after midnight this evening. Of course, Edwina, you were the minister in the DHSS and you outlawed corporal punishment in special schools, didn't you?
I did indeed. I was a teacher before I became a member of parliament, and I'd been a school governor in a number of schools, including one for what we used to call educationally subnormal children. And when I became a minister, I discovered that we never actually outlawed corporal punishment for disabled children in special schools. It took me, I think, about half a day to get it done. You know, it shouldn't happen. Where you've got trained people, trained staff, you don't need corporal punishment. And if you're using it, something is very, very badly wrong.
So what do you make of Michael Gove's other recommendations then? Getting tougher on kids with lines and cleaning up graffiti. Time to get tougher with the punishments. He's not talking about corporal punishment, Edwina. No. Do you think he's got it right?
He's not. Corporal punishment, you're quite right, Stephen, is a red herring. It's been introduced by other people, particularly an older generation.
But back then to the other story, which is going to be talked about all over the news tomorrow, Gove telling the Sun on Sunday, let's get teachers getting harsher on kids with lines and things. What do you think?
What he's done is he's introducing a new code of advice for teachers on discipline. He's reducing it down, he says, to 50 clear, well-written pages. We'll see when it actually comes out. And he's telling them what they can and they can't
but
do.
But do you agree that we need to get tougher?
Yes, indeed. Many, many schools don't have problems. You know, let's be absolutely certain about this. In many, many schools, the children are well-behaved. Schools of many different kinds, particularly where I am in Derbyshire. You look at the Ofsted reports and over again, the kids are in a good environment, safe environment in school, and they're happy about it. But where there is a disruptive child, whatever the reasons for that child's misbehaviour, if he stays in that class, he's disrupting everybody's education, and all the kids are then going to learn is that if you're difficult, you're going to get a lot of attention. What you have to do is pull that child out and, if necessary, get them into a special unit for perhaps a short period of time to sort out what is their real problem.
But this story is about really tough punishments on them.
I once had to do lines at school. What hated it, absolutely hated it, and I behaved a little bit better after that.
So Edwina supports Michael Gove, Sonia.
Well, up to a point.
I mean, the problem is, as I said before, and that is we have to start looking at children as individuals rather than part of a cattle market. And the sooner we do that, the better, frankly, because this whole idea that we start excluding children just because they seem to be behaving in a different way, perhaps they're behaving in a different way because the lessons bore the life out of them, which is not uncommon.
Well, I don't disagree with that, Sonia. That may well be the case. But in many cases now, what's happening in schools and in the classrooms is very much better than it was before. And I must admit, I'm one of those who had to learn by rote, but I'm also a critical thinker. I think the basis of your theories is completely wrong. On the other hand, we have to have
discipline. What do you mean the basis of our theories wrong? What do you mean?
I listened to the lively discussion between Sonia and Anna May. I'm rather more on Anna May's side, I think, in that you can't allow children just to run free. What they do, Sonia, is they wreck the education for other children if they're allowed to just run free and be disruptive.
Who suggested running free?
Yes, you did. I've written it down.
I'm talking about, expanding minds. Because what Gove wants to do and what you appear to be supporting is this whole idea of sort of militarising our school. Remember that they were muting before, quite recently, about this idea of soldiers going into the classroom.
No. You're moving goalposts all the time, Sonia. As a former teacher, I'd ask you to stick to the point, which is in a school environment.
Edwina, you can ask me what you like. There's a whole lot of stuff I'd love to ask you, but this is clearly not the conversation for it.
With soldiers coming into school. It's to do discipline, and discipline is all to do with concentrating, paying attention, listening hard, doing as you are asked, being responsible and respectful for other people, making sure that you create
a shape. Being beaten into a certain shape so that it beats critical thinking out of you. That is exactly what the school system does to you. And this whole idea that you're a teacher,
your daughter chose to go back into the school system.
She didn't choose to go back into the school system for the curriculum, though. She chose to go back in for the social life, not for the. And the problem is that there are.
Well, there you are. You're just defeating your own argument.
No, I'm really not. Trust me, I'm not. There are some good teachers, but there are many bad teachers.
I wouldn't trust you with my pet dog.
Edwina, really Edwina, wouldn't. trust me when I say I would trust you even less, because a whole lot of stuff that you are really culpable for, trust me, really, there are. This isn't the conversation for it, but one day you and I are going to have that conversation and we'll see
I'm feeling really threatened, Sonia.
We don't allow bullying in schools. You just need to know that there is going to come a point when you're going to have to start answering questions. That's what you need to know.
More than happy. Let me give you some idea. I went into a local school recently, Stephen, which had had excellent Ofsted reports, and even more. They did very well in the SATs test. Very, very well. I think a bit to their own surprise.
Okay.
100% everywhere. Where the children are coming out, you know, doing extraordinarily well from very ordinary backgrounds, only about a mile or so from where I live. And I said to her teacher, what are you doing here? What's going on? It looks exactly the same as any other school I've ever been to. And he said, well, there are several things that we're doing. One is we actually, you know, they have 33 children in the class.
Okay.
They bring the children out. We will hear more about this
after 12 when you're looking through the papers.
Sonia, I can't because I'll tell you what,
we're going to miss the news. I can't, but we will bring you back, I promise. Sonia, thank you. Anna May, thank you. Here's the news. Oh, at 11:31.